Okay, that is a young, apparently Western woman lecturing protesters on the streets of Hong Kong. That's according to a Hong Kong online news website. She's telling these pro-democracy, so-called freedom fighters, some of whom have been out there waving American flags, that freedom is not important as apparently Chinese-style safety. So let's discuss it with our Fox News contributors, Leslie Marshall and chairman of the American Conservative Union, Matt Schlapp. Great to have you both with us. Welcome.
Hi, Shin.
Matt, you are recently back from Hong Kong. What's right. your initial reaction to that video? Because I just have so many questions.
Yeah, very typical. You know, this is a question for Hong Kongers, who many of whom want independence, others who just want to have democracy that was promised them when Margaret Thatcher agreed to turn over Hong Kong to Beijing. And what Beijing has done is reneged on almost every promise they made to the UK. And what we're seeing in the streets of Hong Kong is a crackdown, is an abuse of people's individual rights. And it would leave it to a radicalized Westerner, young Westerner, to go over to Hong Kong and lecture these brave democracy activists who, if they continue to do what they do, Shannon, they might lose their lives, they might lose their ability to have a livelihood. Taking on Beijing is not a small matter. And I find it repugnant that this woman did this.
Well, in hot air, under the headline, American lecturers, Hong Kong protesters, and again, we don't know who this person is. The quote is, the idea that it would be better to succumb to Chinese totalitarian communism for the sake of preserving a dialogue overlooks one critical point. It wouldn't be a dialogue between equals. A master speaking to a servant is not a dialogue worth having. Leslie, your reaction to this video?
After I've just come off the floor and fainting and agreeing with Matt on something.
Go, Leslie, go. You know,
okay, here we go. What China said is when they took over from the United Kingdom, Hong Kong, they said, we're not going to get involved in your politics or their economy. And when they talked about extradition, the reason the protesters came out is they knew what that meant. They knew it meant torture. They knew it meant labor camps. They knew that it meant brainwashing. And the bottom line here is for a Western woman to talk about safety versus freedom. How many people, not just in America, historically in the past, and in nations throughout the world, are fighting to the death for their own freedom and for future generations to have that freedom. She's completely wrong. Again, who is she and why should anybody in Hong Kong be listening to her?
Well, in the meantime, I want to get you guys to quickly comment on another story we touched on earlier today in one California neighborhood where the folks there, the neighbors apparently took up a collection, they said. Everybody put in a few $100 and they got these boulders that they've placed on the sidewalk. They say people were, you know, shooting up, selling drugs, sleeping there, passed out overnight, that kind of thing. Here's what a couple of the residents said about what they've done.
Something. We got to do something. Like, I feel like there's nothing being done.
They'll shoot up at night and then stay overnight.
So the boulders are there now. Quickly, reaction from both of you, Matt, and then to you, Leslie.
Look, we see the extreme of communism and the crackdown in Hong Kong and in America. We see this creeping radicalism where homeless people are literally taking over neighborhoods, sleeping on people's private property as well. And California is in a shambles. I know Leslie lives there, but the rest of this country is looking at California and saying, if this is socialism, no thank you.
All right, quick final word to you, Leslie.
This is not socialism. What this is actually capitalism. It's people pushing out individuals that can't afford housing. They're building very expensive housing in Southern California.
3%
and in Northern California. And when they build more houses, they don't have affordable housing or rental units for people. That's why we have more families on the street. What we need is not just legislation that sweeps these people up. What we need is something that's going to protect these neighborhoods, but also address the problem.
And for now, it's the boulders from the neighbors. Thank you.
Okay.